Hello everybody and welcome back to Rimworld. We are rebuilding houses today. We're gonna build Jay's house down here. We got some mining to do before we can get to that. So hopefully some of our colonists will improve their mining skills. Do we have anyone actually set to do mining? Minyaka and Tronka will mine. Currently have a mining skill of 1. All of our colonists have a mining skill of 1. Alright, well, I guess if Minyaka and Tronka get done with all their other tasks, they can start clearing this out. Perfect. I think probably the next person we look to recruit, or maybe we kind of push Crowbar in this direction, is we need somebody who's skilled with mining and maybe crafting. I don't think we really have like a good craftsman. Oh no, Olk is a good craftsman. Cooking, maybe? Tronk is pretty good at cooking. We can just let Tronk continue doing cooking. Mining's really the only hole in our skills that we have. Maybe doctoring too. Yeah. All of our doctors are really poor doctors. But, oh well. Crowbar's on an insulting spree. Wow. So Crowbar, of course, is the child that we adopted into the colony. Right now I'm having Minyaka and Tronka take care of Crowbar, but we'll probably leave it that way. Look, Minyaka and Tronka are already getting to their mining business. Perfect. Alright, looks like winter's upon us. Our plants are starting to die from the cold. 15th of September, yep. It's the end of fall, beginning of winter. Which means our colonists are going to have a lot more time on their hands to do tasks such as mining. I hope we're not wasting all these like component veins by mining them. I know we are. I just hope we're not going to regret wasting all of these like mining resources by mining with poor miners, because I think their yield is significantly lower than it should be. So now that it's winter time, I'm going to go ahead and here. We have these that set to priority normal. We have these set to priority preferred. So all we need to do is change this to important, and then our colonists will go ahead and haul all of this hay into the barn for the animals. Since it's the beginning of winter, we also want to cull our herd, right? We don't want to be taking care of too many animals unnecessarily. So looks like we have 2 calves. I'm not gonna slaughter any young animals, because we want to let them grow to adulthood first. Looks like we're actually doing fine. I don't think we need to do any slaughtering just yet. Look at, we got 3 people on hauling duty here. We're making short work of this. I don't think our animals are going to starve at all this winter. Alright. And we're going to kind of finish this building out here. This will be a nice, house for Jay. The farmhouse. We just need to finish all this mining work. But I mean, on the bright side, our colonists are certainly to get better at mining. Yep, Trunk has almost reached mining level 2. Has anyone reached mining level 2? Nope, not yet. We're getting raided. They intend to use a psychic ritual to summon hideous flesh beasts to attack you. They might perform the ritual multiple times. You need to go and stop them. Oh boy. So there's 2 guys there. Is there just the 2 of them? Oh, these guys don't stand a chance. Just 2 guys. They are equipped with melee weapons, so as long as we keep a distance, we should be fine. Alright. Tronka J. Olga, let's get out there. We need to disrupt this ritual. They're gonna summon zombies. Uh, I don't know why it's struggling so much. There. I don't know why it's struggling so much to put them where I want to put them. Okay, we're gonna set up here. Looks like that we're moving into attack. I don't think they succeeded in doing their ritual. There we go. Oh, we're shooting really well today. Giggles, what a name. Alright, that was easy as you like. And actually, we have a steel mace that seems pretty nice. I'm going to have Minyaka equip the steel mace. Minyaka, go ahead and equip the steel mace. You guys, you're good to go. Well done. I think that's the smoothest raid we've had in a long while. Normally things are not so good for us. Alright, we're going to go ahead and build like a bedroom area in here. We can go ahead and put a couple end tables. I just wanted to check that these end tables ended up with decent quality. Yeah, okay. And so we can go ahead and rotate it around this way. We can put a dresser in the room. I don't know, maybe like here would be a nice place for a dresser. Yeah. Yeah, I think here would be a nice place for a dresser. I think we're going to want another wall here. Then we're going to have this be like the living space and kitchen area. Okay, so Minyaka and Chonka are making short work of this, mining out this house area. And we should be ready to go, ready to move Jay over here so we can dismantle his current house. One thing I do want to be aware of is that it is freezing outside. And we may need to heat the indoor spaces a little better. So we have a vent in here, so we can put a fireplace somewhere. Let's go ahead and go to temperature, campfire. Oh, we already have one. Of course we already have one. We're gonna go ahead and press F to toggle automatic refueling for this campfire. We're also gonna want a campfire in Olga's new room, because it is currently 47 degrees Fahrenheit in this room. Yeah, it's pretty cold. We'll go ahead and put it in the common area. All right, so I think we're gonna go ahead and maybe have like a little kitchen area back here. Next to the kitchen, we can build like a shelf or something that might look nice. We're gonna set this shelf to have nothing actually stored on it. It's just for looks. We can have a nice dining area. I think we wanna, let's have this dining area like right here, right behind the kitchen. And then we can have this kind of be like a living room area. We're gonna need a couch. We're gonna need some nice wood floors. Here we go, wood floors. Perfect. We're gonna want some dining chairs. This person gets a marble table in their house. Fancy. Okay, we're going to go ahead and go to storage settings, and we're gonna say clear all. We don't want anything being stored there. It's just for looks. We've got plenty of available storage in here already. All right, this house is looking great. Jay, I think, should be pretty much ready to move in. We're gonna need some lighting as well. I think that's the last step. We're gonna go ahead and put a torch here to light the space. And we can go ahead and put a torch here to light the space. And other than that, bed, it's a good bed, normal end table, good end table, normal dresser. Okay, things are looking pretty good. We're gonna go ahead and set owner. We're gonna move Jay here. Okay, perfect. Jay, you have a new house. That means we can go ahead and deconstruct your house as it currently exists. Hope you aren't too sentimental and attached to it. One thing I won't deconstruct though is this normal alpaca wool armchair. We're gonna go ahead and reinstall that somewhere because good furniture is in short supply. I think we're gonna go ahead and maybe put that here. And then we can put like a bigger couch right here. Yeah. Change of mind. I'm gonna reinstall it one over right here. We're gonna have a couch here and a couch there. Yep, that'll look nice. We're gonna need a campfire in here too. I think a nice spot for the campfire will be at the end of the table. Alpaca 19 has been torn to death. Oh boy, check this out. There's a lynx on the hunt. I'm gonna set up my crew of archers ready to take out this lynx. Okay, now I want you guys all to... Nope. Fire at the lynx. Okay, we're gonna need to move them a little closer. That's fine. Okay, one at a time. Fire, apparently I can't order them all to do the same thing. Fire at the lynx. Fire at the lynx. Fire at the lynx. The lynx is taking revenge. That's fine. I think we'll be able to kill it before it gets too close. Oh my god, not if we keep missing. Oh my god. They had way too many misses for my comfort level. I just want to check on our shooting skills for all our colonists. Jay is a really good shooter. Trunk is a fantastic shooter. And Olga's actually pretty solid. Alright, we're doing pretty good. We don't want any predators around to slaughter and eat our livestock, so we're going to take care of predators as they kind of wander towards our property. Alright, Jay is hiding in his room. Final straw was being drowsy. Well, sorry Jay, we needed to defend our property from wild animals. Sorry you couldn't handle that. I know you're a little tired. Alright, so we're putting the finishing touches into this house, and then once we're done with that, I think we'll get to deconstructing Jay's old house, and then we can expand out the big family house for Crowbar and Minyaka's unborn child. She's second trimester. Oh, I forgot we have these special abilities for Minyaka. I'm gonna have her try to convert Crowbar. Where is Crowbar? Crowbar's right there. Crowbar, don't go away. I don't wanna interrupt Minyaka. I'm gonna let her finish this couch and then we'll use her power. But yeah, Crowbar currently does not follow our religion, so we need to fix that. Alright, so Minyaka, before you go to bed, I'm going to ask you to try to convert Crowbar. He's going to be a little bit upset about it, but that's okay. We're going to show him the truth. The path of... what is it? How do I find the ideology? Is this it? Yeah, the path of Azim. So now if we go to his bio, we can see his certainty is 67%. Okay, so he's still pretty certain in his own beliefs. Still pretty steadfast, but we'll wear him down over time. So I just wanted to take a moment to check in on Crowbar's learning, and it looks like he's keeping his learning skill, his learning meter pretty high consistently. So we're happy to see that. He's still age 3, and I think his next growth moment is like at age 6 or 7 or something. So he has a while to get there, but hopefully we can put him up to a significant like growth tier, maybe 4 or 5 or something. That can let us have a lot of flexibility when choosing traits for him as he grows up. Stone cutting, we're more than half of the way there. Keep it up, Tronka. You're doing great. You're doing God's work here. Oh, wow. Look at this. Once great house with no more. Okay. So our next step has to be adding on some new wings. So we're gonna have a little kitchen area right here. We're gonna add on a child's bedroom right here. I think this was gonna be like the master bedroom. And is this just gonna go like that? I honestly can't remember. But that's fine. We're gonna go ahead and build out some walls like this. We're going to probably need to like reconfigure some, shuffle around some furniture here for the meanwhile while we kind of sort out how we want this to go. Sorry, Minyak and Tronka, your bedroom is going to be a little bit of a disaster for the time being. This is going to be a really big house. I guess it's 3 bedrooms, so it's kind of got to be. Interesting point of order. One thing that's making these bedrooms nice is I'm avoiding putting a door to the bedrooms so that they technically the bedroom includes the living area. This is going to increase the like perceived size of the bedroom. That's just like how the game mechanics work. It's just a game mechanics thing. There's a mad doe, so I paused the game because I don't want any of us to die foolishly from a mad doe. What happened to Minyaka, by the way? When did Minyaka and Olga get into a fight? Like, I completely missed this or what? I was just talking my head off over there. Alright, well let's go ahead and deal with this mad doe. Olga? No time to rest. Need you to get out there. Come on, Tronka. There you go. Nice shooting. Perfect. Don't you dare. Oh my god, it's gonna... I thought it was gonna attack our poor child. If that was our second child that would be mauled by a wild animal in this playthrough. So disappointed. Alright, and we're being raided by the Gora Union. This is a big raid. Wow, they're coming at us with 4 people. That's just as many people as we have to defend it, so we're going to be pretty evenly matched. So we need to take our strategy pretty seriously to make sure we can win this fight. So let's see what they're coming at us with, and let's see if there's any like really skilled fighters that we need to target down first. Kaida is coming at us with a short bow and kind of sucks at shooting. Dragon is coming at us with a Ikwa, which is like a spear, I think, and kind of sucks at melee, so we don't really need to be too worried. A club sucks at melee. And this person is good at melee. Okay, so Krika is somebody we want to take out at a distance. Of note, they're all also wearing... Oh, I thought they were helmets. They're just toques. Okay, no. So they're not wearing any like body armor. So we should be good on that front. Now, seems like there's only one person armed with a bow and the rest of them are armed with clubs. Yeah, so it's only Kaida armed with a bow. So range is going to be our advantage that we need to take advantage of. So I'm going to go ahead and set our colonists up here in preparation for the raid. Oh. I think we're just gonna position here instead because they're already making progress. They're coming down. I don't like this. Once they're in the kind of heart of our base, we lost our advantage, our range advantage. But unfortunately, there's not much we can do. Okay. Let's be smart about this though. I don't actually like that. We're gonna position our people in the corners where they have better cover. So Olga can go here. Vinyaka can hang out without cover. Okay. Vinyaka, I'm gonna need you to go around the corner here. Oh, come on, you're gonna need to shoot better than that. Okay. I'm gonna move Vinyaka in. Start taking out Yak. Crowbar, I'm gonna need you to go inside. Okay, Vinyaka needs to continue. Okay. Tronka, I'm gonna have you do a tactical retreat. Nope, too late. Tronka didn't get the chance to. So we're gonna go ahead and have Vinyaka provide cover for Tronka as he does a tactical retreat. Tronka, I'm gonna move you up here. And I'm going to have you target Dragon for me. There we go. We have 2-on-1. Okay. We successfully defeated that raid. It did not go well, though. That could have gone a lot better. Any permanent injuries we need to be aware of? No. We're doing okay. This cut scar isn't fresh, is it? I don't think it is. Okay. Perfect. We're gonna go ahead and unrecruit everybody and let them get back to their business. One point of order, I noticed that the child was doing some hauling. We don't want the child to do any work. We want the child just to be focused on learning. We want the child to maximize their learning time. We don't need them doing any kind of manual labor around the colony. I mean, it's a 3-year-old child, for Christ's sake. Their only responsibility is being a child. Interesting. We could take this person prisoner. Do they have anything to contribute to our colony? Notably, we need a miner. And no, they do not. Are they good at medical either? No. Okay, so we're just going to let Krika die. Well, I don't think we need to try to save Krika or anything. Vinyaka is tending to Jay. Perfect. Tronka should hopefully be tending to some other people as well. Has Olga been treated yet? Nope. Shouldn't Vinyaka, Tronka, and Jay all be prioritizing doctoring? Okay, well, Jay, now that you've been treated, I'm going to have you prioritize tending to Olga. And Tronka, I'm going to have you prioritize tending to Vinyaka. Is Vinyaka already treated? Yep. Is Tronka already treated? No. Okay, then Vinyaka, I'm going to need you to prioritize tending to Tronka. Looks like some of our animals are suffering from hypothermia. I don't think our cows are built for cold weather. We're going to need to sort that out, and I think... Let's go into their information. Let's see, what is their minimum comfortable temperature? It is negative 10. And currently it is negative 25 Celsius. Okay, so we're gonna wanna probably, a couple torches could do the trick in here. If I have like a torch here and a torch here. I wanna try to do this without a full blown campfire because I think those are really hungry for wood. But let's see if two torches could do the trick in here. Vinyaka, I want you to prioritize working on this lamp. Okay, so now it should hopefully be just a little bit warmer in there. Vinyaka, can you also prioritize working on this lamp too. Perfect. Okay, so it should be just a little bit warmer. All of our cows might die this season, and if they do, so be it. I didn't realize that cows are not built for cold weather. You kind of need to barn them up in the summer. In the winter, I mean. Olga's on an insulting spree. Poor mood. Serious pain. Okay, he's gonna insult a child, it says. He's gonna follow around Crowbar insulting him. Wow, that's real mature of you, Olga. Olga, this child is not the source of your problems and your woes, okay? Take it out on, like, the dead bodies of the raiders if you have to. Insult them. Poor kid. Poor kid. Okay, so... are our cows still struggling with frostbite? Or hypothermia, I guess? I don't think so. I think they're doing okay now. They have a warm place they can go to now in case of freezing. We should probably build a couple more torch lamps though. There we go. We can have one there. We can have one there. All right. So this house plan is almost complete. We're gonna wanna move this baby toy to somewhere else. Yeah, we can move it there. And we can put a wall here. Alright, I think we'll go ahead and end the episode here. Hopefully in the next episode soon, everyone can recover quickly from their raid injuries. And hopefully we can get this house completed in the next episode. And then our colonists will be living in style and comfort and luxury. I really like the way these new houses are shaping up. It really feels like this is more of like a village rather than like a master planned kind of utility and production focused colony. Like I feel like these colonists are a lot more happy. I'm really happy with the way this is turning out. So I hope you guys continue to watch the series in the future as we continue to make fun designs for our base and maybe get this base a little more defensible with some walls and some stoneworking. Yeah, we have a lot to look forward to. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.